Tonight's mailbag is assisted by Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout from Oxus Brewing Company in Winnipeg. They describe it as an easy-drinking dark ale with the aroma of coffee and chocolate and a smooth body from the oats that are used in the mash. So, the first item in says PC drive on it. Have I ordered any more circuit board or PC drives? We have one of those satisfaction things. Oh, that's not PC drive at all. What that is, in fact, is some 5.2 millimeter power jacks. Looks like 10 of them. These are super common with just generic power bricks and stuff. Some of the older laptop power bricks I've got use them. And of course, these little terminals use them. And they are just, they're as close to a standard as you can get for these barrel jacks. I mean, there's lots of other sizes, but these are the most common ones. And I do go through them, so.
10 pieces DC power jack, 5.2 millimeter by 2.1 millimeter. 10 pieces for a whole 99 cents Canadian with free shipping. There's no other information about them down here, but that doesn't really matter. The photos and the description, the measurements are more than enough to know that this is close enough to what I want. Especially for the price. They're like 10 cents each. How can you go wrong?
Off to a good start. What do we got in next? Ah, it's a donation that somebody sent to my P.O. box. Thank you, whoever it was, for whatever this is. It is some blank perf board. Blank PCB perf board. 5 centimeter by 7 centimeter. That's a handy little size for a lot of just quick toss together one-off circuits. I do go through this stuff. I've bought several different sizes of it over the years, and it is something that I do rebuy frequently, so nice to have. Thank you to whoever sent these in.
Since this was sent in and I don't have a listing for it, I am going to put a search link down below that finds it. Hell of a deal, too. 5 pieces for 99 cents with free shipping. You can't do much better than that for something cheap and consumable like this. Excellent.
All right, moving right along. We have components. Well, that's nice and generic. Any guesses? Any guesses? Ah, it is 2 little breadboards. Those are always handy to have. And again, they're something that it's just super handy for throwing together a quick circuit just to play with, just to experiment with. You can join them together like that if you want to, or like that to make them wider or longer just for convenience, or you can use them separately. I tend to keep a lot of circuits that I've experimented with just on breadboards for an extended period of time, just if it's something that I revisit now and again and I don't want to have to tear it down and rebuild it every time. So it's always handy to have a few of these. And if I remember correctly, I was able to get these ones at auction.
Yes, it was an auction. 1-piece new Solderless breadboard 400 point tie prototype test board PCB. Got this one at auction for 63 cents Canadian. And on the same day, got the other one for 54 cents Canadian at auction. And again, from the same seller, so he packaged them together. But since that was an auction, the link I'm going to put down below is to a search for it. As always, sorted price plus shipping lowest, which tends to bring up the auction ones at the top anyway. Currently, there's some on auction for 41 cents Canadian. So who knows, you might get lucky. But at the very least, you're still searching by lowest price first. And even if you're not getting one at auction, they're like less than $1.50. So
far, so good. A bunch of handy things that are tend to be consumables around here. What is next? We have 2 pieces of PCB solder mask. Really? Oh, yeah. What do we have here? UV curable solder mast. Not mask. This one appears to be blue. And this one appears to be black, if my old colorblind eyes aren't deceiving me. So what this is essentially a type of thick paint that is electrically insulating. You can put on your circuit board, in this case, on a repaired circuit board, just to insulate and protect, provides some humidity protection as well, but it's mostly for insulation protection. And then when you're soldering close to one track, it doesn't let the solder creep across onto the next track, onto the one that's protecting. So I think, oh yeah, it is still liquid. Good. So I think those will be handy when I'm doing a repair or putting together a circuit with tight tolerances or something like that. I've never actually had any of this before to play with, but it should be handy to have. It looks like there are 6 different types available. This is this type and this type, so I'm assuming that there are 4 other colors that I didn't get. I don't know whether I should get more colors of this or not. Maybe I'll just stick with these two for now, see how much I use them, and carry on from there.
10cc UV curable solder mask PCB BGA circuit board protect soldering paste. The blue one cost me $5.83 Canadian, or $6.45 if you happen to be in Australia. Huh. And the other one was green, and that cost me $3.59 Canadian. Much cheaper. Presumably green is more common and therefore higher volume? I don't know. So it looks like colors that you could get, but not from this seller. Red, black, blue, green, yellow, white. Okay. Those are all fairly standard colors. If you're ordering from any of the PCB houses, you can get your solder mask done in those. After the wiring's finished, directly coat the welding oil. Gently warm the goods with a wind gun and place them in the sun for a short time. Sure, the sun is a handy and convenient source of UV, or you could just shine a UV light on them.
And now, the last and largest package in. This is another one that has come from my P.O. box, and this says pens, red ink, blue ink. Okay. Wonder if that's really what it is. Ooh. That's a fancy looking pen. And it came with this little Yuping package. I wonder what that is. Oh. Those look like fountain pen ink cartridges. To me, they look like they're all blue. So that would mean that this is it's a fountain pen. Wow, I haven't messed with one of these since I was in school and we were all trying to be fancy. So if I remember correctly, you open that up and one of the cartridges goes in there. And then, yeah, there we go. Well, that's nice and smooth. Wow. Thank you to whoever sent this. I don't know how you guessed that I had some kind of a nostalgic connection to this kind of a pen, but wow, thank you.
If my searching is correct, this is a Jinhao X750 calligraphy ink pen. On the barrel here on mine, it does say Jinhao X750, so I'm quite confident, and this does look like the same pattern, the one that I got. Looks like they're currently selling for about $6.79 Canadian. But this particular listing doesn't have the ink included. As usual, I'll link you to a search listing with a price plus shipping lowest first sort setup. And you can dig through here and find what you're interested in if this is something that appeals to you.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Wow, wow, wow. Lots of neat stuff. Most of it is stuff that I consider to be consumables around here. Like these perf boards, they just get used in all kinds of little circuit, one-off circuits like that. And, you know, they're cheap. They do the job. That's what you want. Also cheap and does the job. We have these 2 solderless breadboards. As I said, I'll often leave circuits set up on them for weeks or longer at a time. So it's nice to have those. Plus, here's one that I use for plugging stuff in when I'm soldering header pins on. I want to keep them in alignment. And you notice that it's gotten kind of melty over time. So, again, at the price, these things were super duper cheap. It's not bad to have some more of them kicking around. Then we have this solder mask. Again, it's consumable. It's something that you use when you're insulating repair work and stuff like that. So it's just good to have around. Even these little plugs. As I said, they don't fit directly into circuit board mounting holes unless you've specifically designed a circuit for them. But that's okay. I can tag a lead onto them or something, or just use flying wires for these. And again, those things tend to get used quite often around here. And then we have this cool fountain pen. Quite reasonably priced too. Feels really good. Nice weight to it. Makes a nice line on the paper. I'm blown away. As I said, I have some nostalgia for those because we did use those for a time back in middle school. Wow, fun. Thank you everybody for watching. Thank you so much for the folks that send this stuff in. Thanks to my Patreon supporters, my YouTube channel members, the people who click super thanks on the videos, all that kind of stuff. It just keeps me happy and keeps me wanting to do this, which is great. So this is mailbag number 199. In 2 weeks' time, it'll be number 200. I'm thinking of doing something a little bit slightly different, a little bit special. If you've got any ideas or suggestions, drop them down in the comments. I have an idea, but if somebody comes up with something better, I might do that or add it in. I can't believe I've been doing these things for so long, and people keep enjoying and watching them. So thank you for that. What else do I say? Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.